Hello everyone. In today's session, we will be covering a very important issue for different departments when they are working in D35 finance and operation. And the important thing which is relevant with the attachments to the documents. And if I can show you, just go to any of the documents such as purchase order or maybe vendor payment journal. So for example, if I go to the vendor payment journal, so on the right hand side at the top, you can see the attachment feature. So this feature is basically, if I click it, so you can attach any of the PDF or Word document as a supplementary documents to relevant with this ledger journal table or the payment journal. So that it is, for example, can be a deposit slip, it can be a check copy or manual check copy or anything relevant with this journal. So similarly for the purchase order also, so within the purchase order, if you select any of the purchase order here, so you can go here and attach any of the documents. So mostly the concerned persons who are working in each of the document, they know about this feature, but sometime there is a difficulty when you have a posted document, because the system by default does not allow an attachment for a posted document. So this is a problem, because sometime when you post a payment journal, so later on there is a deposit slip, maybe it is online or maybe it is a manual deposit slip which you need to attach as a proof of payment to the vendor. So similarly, same is true for any of the other documents. Once it is posted, you still need to attach some additional scanned document, or maybe not scanned, then digital documents like PDFs or any of Word or Excel documents with those D35 documents. So first of all, let me brief about the attachment feature. So let's go to the module which is called Organization and Administration. And in Organization and Administration, as you can see, there is a group called Document Management. So within that group, you have multiple options like active document tables. And this one is related with the attachments to each of the document, like purchase order or payment journal or maybe invoice journal. So these are the active document table. But before that, I just need to show you the document management parameters. And this is document management framework, which is basically called like attachment. When you attach any of the document to the D35 documents. So first of all, there is a one parameter, which is the main, I would call it a main switchboard. This is called use active document tables. So presently, you can see in front of you that this checkbox is selected as no, and it can be also enabled as a yes. So when it is no, so it means the you are not using active document tables. But in that case, what system does is you can attach all of the, you know, the attachment is enabled to all of the existing documents. So when you choose it as a yes, so it means then you need to define specifically to which document you need to enable the attachments. So this is how this function works. So if I select yes, and then I go to the purchase order, I showed you before also, attachments were enabled. If I now go and, for example, this is an open order, and then I go to the attachment, you can see now it is disabled. Now it will only allow for the enabled active document tables. So this is the first feature which I need to just tell you. So just I will enable it. Sorry, I will disable it. So once I disable, it means now for each of existing document, it will be enabled. So the second thing is, so I need to just go to the accounts payable and vendor payment journal, and you can see here, for example, this is a workflow enabled as you can see, this vendor payment draft is workflow enabled document, which is still not submitted and not approved. So this vendor payment journal is still in draft, but if you go to this one, 644, here you can see in the workflow view history is shown, and this one is approved document. This is vendor payment journal, which is approved. Okay. So how the system behaves when the parameter is turned off, means it is enabled for all of the document. So for the workflow approved document, also you can see from by inserting a column here. So that is workflow approval state status. You will just select it and drag it a bit so that it is visible. You can see that this document is approved and this one is draft. The other one is not enabled for workflow, because once I enable the workflow, then only I created these, so the workflow were enabled after workflow was enabled, so the workflow was showing in these two documents later on created. So for example, if I go to this draft document, I can still attach any of the file, note, image or URL. But what about the approved? So let me close this, go to this approved one, and I go here, and you can see here there is the options are disabled. Why? After approving it, the option is not available, and it will work like a workflow to be consistent with the workflow. Is you cannot change anything within the document until it is again resubmitted or it is edited here. Once it is edited, again you need to submit in workflow, and then only at that time when it is in draft, you can attach any of the document. So sometime when you have approved it, later on you pay to the vendor. So how to attach the, for example, deposit slip, which comes later on, and it need to be attached here for the later reference, or anybody who wants to see it for audit purpose or anything, how you will enable this. So this is a very important thing, basically, which is function which the D365 system supports. So how to enable that? First you need to know which table, basically. This is a because this is a form, but behind it there is a table. A table is used to store the records. So here, on once you right click any of the form, so in the form information you can see the form name, which is called ledger journal table for a vendor payment. And this ledger journal table is not only for vendor payment, but mostly the journals, for example in JV or any other journals, they are using this as a header table. So there are definitely lines also which are ledger journal trans. So this ledger journal table form name you can find from here, or you can see the menu item in the URL. This is MI, means the menu item, and here you can see ledger journal table, the name of the table or the name of the form. Because Microsoft keeps it consistent, the form name is same as the table name which is behind this form or page. So first you need to identify which is the table behind this form in order to enable the attachment for the posted documents or approved documents. So first you identify ledger journal table is the document, then you go to the organization and administration, and first we have checked these parameters. Now we will go to the active document tables. So here you need to define the table name against which you need to enable the attachment feature even after approval. So I have identified this as ledger journal table, so I just need to click new option, new button, and then I need to select from this these tables ledger journal table. So this is the table which we are concerned here, and once you select it, add a row for this. So the table ID is also filled on the left hand side, and on the right hand side you can see always enabled feature. So it means you need to check this or select this as yes and save it. So now what it will do, basically, it will enable the attachment feature, whatever the status of the document is, or whatever status of the row is. Means it is in approved state, it is in draft state, it will always enable the attachment feature. So now I need to go back to accounts payable and go to the vendor payment journal. Okay, so because I did not save my view, so the workflow status is gone. I can again insert, no problem, and just filter by workflow approval status. Let's put it here, and this you can see at the standard view, it is showing a star, means unsaved. So what I can do, I can save this as my view. Save it. So the my view, now it will show me this column whenever I select my view. So now here you can see in the approved before it was not enabled. Now if you can go to this one, so now it is enabled. And now I can attach a file here. So any of the file, for example, I can attach this book XLS, or if there is a deposit slip, or I can also attach that one as a proof. So I will open it and select it and give it, for example, a name like deposit slip. So I will save it. So now you can see that it allows the attachment feature even after the approval of the vendor payment journal. So this is a very useful feature for accountants. Once they have posted or they have approved, they have the approved documents like vendor payment journal or vendor invoice journal, or can be JV journal voucher. So they can basically enable this feature from the document management active document tables. So this is, I think, is a very useful tip for the employees who are working daily on the daily basis to the documents within DSRIS 5. Thank you very much for watching the video, and stay tuned. Thank you.